My name is Robert G. Makar, but most people call me Bobby. I'm a 22-year-old electronic media production major at Kent State University. I grew up in Streetsboro, Ohio, which is a little bit out of Kent. I was always a very visual kid. I used to like pictures and things like that and movies, and that's really what has stuck with me is movies and comics and music. I just latch on to creative shit. When I'm stable long enough, I start to look around for love. I think I have like a strong desire to create things. That's always been very dominant in my life. I've always wanted to make things. I've always wanted to build things. And when I used to play with stuff, like my toys and stuff, I always used to want to make stories. It's always been this desire to create things.
Okay, my first impression of Bobby, I met him, I think, in my writing for electronic media class. I don't know, he just seemed like a guy who was really into art and comic books, for sure comic books.
I have a very, very strong love for comic books. It's really been the backbone of my existence, I would say. I kind of grew up with them. Ever since I can remember, I've loved comic books. I really like drawing quite a bit and a little watercolor painting every now and then, but I wouldn't consider myself an artist necessarily. I consider an artist to be one who has great insight into something and then can express it with intense passion and a certain skill of tact.
Bobby's in almost all my classes, and in almost every class he's always doodling. That's just Bobby. That's just what he does. He's always drawing. He draws really good pictures of himself too. Like, it really looks like him. And he draws good like characters of other people, but I also heard that he's really good with film.
My love for movies is vast and very powerful, much more intense than the love I've ever felt for a woman. I love to obsess over movies, and I love just to be part of movies. And my favorite filmmaker in the entire world is Kevin Smith. When I see his movies, I look at him and I see part of myself, and Clerks changed my life, and this is the t-shirt I was wearing when I met Kevin Smith, which I consider to be the single most awesome experience of my entire life. Some people fall in love and get married, and I got to meet Silent Bob, so I find that to be an even trade-off. With movies, I'm always trying to emulate Clerks, Reservoir Dogs, High Fidelity, and Annie Hall, because I think that's a foursome of awesomeness.
I watched a movie that Bobby made, and the first thing I thought was it was High Fidelity if it was starring Woody Allen. And I know that those are two of Bobby's biggest influences, and it really came through in that film.
His movie was called Everything is Anna.
Everything is Anna is a short movie. It's 18 minutes. We did it for Video Field Production. It was really a labor of love because it was one of those things where it could just be a project for a class, or it could be something that is a little more than that. But that was the first little screenplay that I ever finished, and so I was really proud of that.
It was excellent. It was very artistic. It had a lot of different camera angles. It had good lighting. It was great. There was this one library shot where they're walking down one of the aisles in the library, and the way the camera's like dolling through, it was a really awesome shot. That was probably my favorite shot in the whole movie. It was a really good concept. He's a really creative guy.
I came up with this movie titled The Dean's List. So basically it's about a guy who has to kill his professor's ex-wife after he fails an exam in order to pass the class and graduate college.
I will do anything. Go get your A. All you have to do is find my wife. Killer.
So he finds an aloof detective who's just out for sex, and he finds this wacky arms dealer who really has no idea what he's doing and collects toys and is just a big child. So the three of them kind of form and try to find this lady and kill her so he can pass college. And we just basically shot this crummy little trailer, and I had no production value put into it at all. We had such a good time, and it means like so much to me that I wouldn't want to redo it because it's very personal, and we had a really great time doing it.
The Dean's List.
I don't want to die alone.
Everybody dies alone.
I don't want to die alone.
I have a couple jobs. One of them is at Teleproductions here on campus, and it is fantastic. I work with great people. I work for great people. We do great things. And it's all around great.
I've worked with Bobby for a couple of years now at Teleproductions, and just things are very lively when he is around, and it makes work more enjoyable when he's around, because he cracks jokes all the time, and just people like when he's around.
My day job is at Giant Eagle, where I stack produce and wear a dorky uniform. Every weekend, I give a little bit more of my soul away to the corporate masses. I don't really like the people there any much.
Bobby's very talented in many realms. He's very good at writing movies and such, and he's very good at drawing, and he's also pretty good at playing guitar.
I first started playing guitar when I was a freshman in high school because I was chubby and girls didn't talk to me, and I had a thing for Richie Sambora, not in like a sexual way. My all-time favorite record is by the band Weezer, and it's called Pinkerton. It is 10 songs of pure emotion, just grinding guitars, some synthesizers. And when I'm at Giant Eagle, oftentimes people will see me singing the album to myself because it's the one album I can sing straight through. Something that I've always kind of like identified with is that idea that you're kind of on the outside of things and you're just kind of looking in, and there's something kind of off about you. So you gotta squeal guitars just to make up for it. Much like slaves in the South used to sing like African hymns, I sing Pinkerton. I don't wanna be an old man anymore. It's been a year or two since I was out on the floor. Chicken booty making sweet love all the night. This time I got back to the good life.
I definitely think that Bobby in the future, it has a big good future in writing and producing and directing films, because I think he's very talented at writing, and I hope that works out for him.
Like, that's my goal, is to be a part of real movies someday. God only knows where that's going to translate. Hopefully not porn. I'm a guy like you. One time a girl called me a violator, and I'm not sure why. Yeah.
Is this at the club?
No. No, this is a real person.